The researches have various purposes for its conduction. Sometimes the researchers conduct the researches for checking whether a particular problem can be solved in future. At times it is conducted for checking what happened in the history, whereas at times it is conducted to see what is the present scenario. Similarly, at times it is also conducted for checking whether the purpose of the program has been achieved, how far it has been successful, and so on. And such kind of researches, they all come in under the category of evaluation research. Before we get on to the details of evaluation research, we shall first see the definition of the term evaluation. Evaluation is a systematic acquisition and assessment of information to provide useful feedback about some subject. Those amongst us who come from the background of education or sociology, they are very well versed with this definition of evaluation, that there are certain objectives set and the achievement or the progress is checked against those objectives, and that is something called as the evaluation. This same focus is used in the definition of evaluation studies. So we shall now see some of the definitions of evaluation studies. Before we go on to the definitions, the concept of evaluation studies is applicable in multiple areas, multiple disciplines, such as sociology, social research, education, behavioral research, even scientific research. So we shall see these definitions, which have different focus depending upon the discipline for which that definition is being used. So we shall go through them one by one. Research undertaken to see whether a program or an activity is meeting or has made the objectives set for it. As you see, this definition is having the focus of social research. And like from the definition, you can make it that the focus is social research. We shall see the second definition. The systematic application of social research procedures in assessing social intervention programs. In this definition, the social intervention programs are in focus. So this definition is from the sociology angle. We shall see the next one. The use of scientific research methods to plan intervention programs, to monitor the implementation of new programs and the operation of existing programs, and to determine how effectively programs or clinical practices achieve their goals. From this definition, you can make out that this has a focus of the scientific research, since there were mentions of terms like clinical researches, clinical data. So that is the indication of that definition is especially for the scientific researches. We shall see the last definition now. The research in order to consider the effectiveness of new or existing programs, procedures, and or interventions at producing some form of outcome or change. Here the most important term is the effectiveness. This term is many a times used in the area of education. This definition has the focus of education as a discipline. The findings of the evaluation research in education would have the focus on something like to what extent the intervention or the measure that was taken was successful, which areas was it needs still further improvement, and so on. There are four main types of the evaluation studies or evaluation researches. They are school surveys, program evaluation, follow-up studies, replication, and secondary data analysis. So, of course, as they all are the types of evaluation studies, the commonality amongst all four of them is the purpose, that is, the evaluation is the purpose. To what extent the goals have been achieved, to see that is the purpose, that is the commonality. But we shall now see in detail how they are different at the micro level. The first one we shall discuss is the school surveys. Now, the concept of survey is very much familiar to us. We have also discussed the concept of survey in detail in the descriptive type of researches and also in the survey type of researches. In school surveys is a special category of these surveys from the angle of evaluation, and that is why school surveys is a type of evaluation studies. As the name suggests, school surveys are completely related to and also limited to only school environment. Whatever inputs are given at the school, whatever learning environment is provided, whatever learning activities are given to the students, to what extent are they successful, whether the students are happy about it, whether what do the teachers have to say, what stand do the parents take about it. All these are studied in the school surveys. We shall see the definition of the school surveys. The school surveys, they give each school important insight into what staff, students and parents think about their school's learning environment. So as you can see from the definition, there are three main stakeholders of whatever happens in the school. The first one, of course, are students for whom the whole efforts are taken. The second one are those people who are taking the efforts, the teachers and administration of the school. And the third one is a part of the society in the form of parents. So whenever the school surveys are conducted, these three stakeholders are kept in focus. What their expectations are, what their challenges are, and to what extent they are happy about what is happening. School surveys can be conducted individually or by the group. Now, this person who is individual or a group can be the people who are part of the school, or it can be a third party evaluation study as well. We come across such school surveys many a times, and that is something very much familiar to many of us. The school survey can be about all the learning experiences that the students are given in the school, or it could be focused to a particular subject or a particular activity. For example, it could be only a science club, or the activities related to the language laboratory and so on. So depending on the focus, the scope of the school survey would differ. But the main focus of any school survey is definitely the students are in focus. The school surveys are conducted keeping in view the benefits that are going into for the students and so on. We shall move on to the second type of evaluation studies, that is the program evaluation. Now, the focus of this kind of evaluation study is also very clear from the title itself, that is some program is being evaluated. Now, what would the program will be evaluated against? It is evaluated against the goals or the objectives that were kept in view before the program was offered. We shall see the actual definitions of this type of evaluation research. The systematic collection of information about the activities, characteristics and outcomes of programs for use by specific people to reduce uncertainties, improve effectiveness and make decision with regard to what those programs are doing and affecting. So as we have seen earlier, this definition speaks about the objectives that were kept in mind earlier, and the program evaluation gives an opportunity to check to what extent these objectives have been achieved and where improvements are needed. We shall see one more definition of program evaluation. The systematic application of social research procedures for assessing the conceptualization, design, implementation and utility of social intervention program. It is clear that the social research is in focus in this particular definition. So here, how sociologically it has made any impact and where improvements are needed are studied in this type. There are certain questions which one needs to ask oneself while taking up any program evaluation study. We shall see some of these questions. These questions are very useful for being focused on what is expected at the end of the program evaluation study. So these questions are: does the program match the values of stakeholders or needs of the people being served. So here, suppose the stakeholders are the students, of course, but at the same time, even the people in the market. So if they are happy about the program, then that is something really worth adding to the program. If the market clientele is happy about the students that are coming out of the program, then the inputs of the program are really of good quality. And that is the feedback given to the people who have been designing the program for the students. Does the program as implemented fulfill the plans? Sometimes it happens that certain activities are planned for the students in a program. Certain modalities are planned for them. For example, like for this particular content, they would have seminars. For this particular another type of content, they would have field visits and so on. So by asking this kind of a question, the researcher gets an idea about whether these plans were actually implemented, to what extent it was implemented, what were the hurdles for implementation, and so on. So this gives an idea for further improvement, further modification in the way the program is offered for the next batches. Do the outcomes achieved match the goals? Every program has its certain goals, and whether that has been achieved, whether the outcome is exactly what was planned, what was decided, pre-decided rather, before the program was offered to the clientele or to the target group, that is checked in the program evaluation. Is there support for program theory? While every program is conceived, there is a lot of deliberations, there is a lot of theoretical foundation behind it. And whether whatever output has been achieved, whether it is in consensus with that theory, and whether it is giving any inputs for enriching the theory, that is also checked during program evaluation. Is the program accepted? This is once again related to the students going to the world of work. Whether the world of work accepts the inputs that are given during the program is in the focus while addressing this kind of a question. Are the resources devoted to the program being expended appropriately? For every program, there are lots of resources used. Some of them are maybe technological resources, physical resources, human resources, and so on. So whether they are really exploited completely, whether they are used to the maximum level for the program, that is something that is checked while asking such kind of a question. So these were some of the questions which person who is taking up a program evaluation would have in mind before taking up a research.